From the Endergroove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands, my name is Mix Master G and welcome to this tutorial. My job is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my job is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs so you have more time on your hand to spend at the creative part of things. Today's tutorial is going to be from Traktor Windows to Rekordbox Windows. Now, don't get me wrong. The actual conversion will still take place on Mac OS. And that is because I'm a Mac OS only guy. The code of my apps is virtually portable. I can use it on any platform, but my in-depth knowledge on Windows is limited. Well, my in-depth knowledge of Mac OS is pretty deep. So that means I can fix problems even if it's not a problem with my apps. And I want to provide that level of support to my customers. And that's the reason why I'm Mac OS only. I know more about that than about other platforms. As simple as that. Having said that, the Mac OS you are going to use can be in a virtual machine. The Mac OS you are going to use can be on a remote computer you don't have even access to. It can be on, it doesn't matter where that Mac OS is, as long as it is a Mac OS. It doesn't have to be newest Mac OS. It can be even as low as version 10.11, El Capitan. The only requirement is that Mac OS must have access to the internet and it must have my conversion apps on it. And that's all it requires. Let's take you to the Windows part of things and show you how you convert from Traktor Windows to Rekordbox Windows. Here we are, and as you see, a simple Traktor straightforward collection. I'm not a Windows user, so my Traktor Windows collection is just a little bit tiny to show you the ropes. Let's use the Professional Widow track as a reference track, so that will be the track I use to show you how this all works. You can see it got the cue set by Traktor as the starting point of the track. I got a loop and I got another loop. And please notice that those two loops are at the wrong position. Loop 3 is in front of loop 2, and actually we would like to see them the other way around, and that will be fixed automatically later on. I have to export the collection to an NML file, and for the sake of simplicity I put it on the desktop. Don't rename it, just leave it $collection. Put it on the desktop. Don't forget to disable the copy tracks to destination, otherwise you will run out of disk space pretty quickly, and give it an OK. That's all I need to do as a preparation. Next up is to get that collection NML to the Mac OS side of things. Well, I'm running in a virtual environment. I'm running in parallel, so I just can simply drag and drop it over. However, if you have the Mac OS on an entirely different Mac and maybe miles and miles away, you can just mail it. Zip that collection, because if you compress it, you save a lot of space and that mail will go very, very fast. Zip it and send it over to your buddy who has a Mac OS computer. I just drag and drop it out of the virtual environment into the Macintosh environment. And let me hide the virtual environment. I start up the DJ conversion utility, and of course we are going from Traktor. I tell it that this will be a Windows conversion, and I have to point it to the correct collection, and that is the collection NML on my desktop. That is the one I just drag and dropped from my virtual environment. Next up, is it exactly as it is on the Macintosh side of things? Let's take the beat marker as a cue, because in our reference track there is a beat marker that is set as a cue. And for the rest of it, it's simply start the conversion, select all the playlists of the Traktor collection you want to convert, and let the DJ conversion utility do its magic. Once it's done, we have inside the documents folder, the ATDR production team folder, the Rekordbox DGSU XML. That is the file we need back inside the Windows collection. We can double check in Rekordbox Macintosh if it is valid XML. However, that's not required at all. You can just compress that, zip that, make it a little bit smaller and mail it back. Or in our case, just go back to the virtual environment and just drag and drop it in. There it is. The next part is getting that record box DGCU inside record box. And for that, I already have prepared some footage on the macOS side of things, how to do it in Rekordbox Mac. But this works exactly the same in Windows. So watch that, and after that, I will take this Rekordbox DGCU XML inside my Rekordbox collection and show you the reference file to show you that everything indeed converted. The Rekordbox XML and how it works is one of the counterintuitive things of Rekordbox. But once you get your head around it, it's not that difficult at all. You have to keep in mind that a Rekordbox XML is a transmission mechanism. You use it to in or export data into Rekordbox. It is not your collection. It is not actively maintained. And you cannot create a CDJ USB out of it. You can only do that from tracks in the collection. How to tell the difference? Right here, this is your Rekordbox collection, and you can see some test files there. These are the collection playlists that can be used to create a CDJ drive. And then we go to the Rekordbox XML part. Before you move there, you have to set the preferences right. If Rekordbox is installed on the same macOS as you run my apps on, those preferences will be set automatically. First of all, under the View tab, you set the Rekordbox XML on, so it displays right there. Then you move to the Analysis tab. This is rather personal how you set it, but these are the recommended settings. I like to disable the analyzation of BPM and key because I want to import that information from the Rekordbox XML. I enable the auto analysis because analyzation is still required to get a graphical representation of the audio track. It is crucial that you got the write the value to ID3 text disabled in the key analysis, otherwise your track files tags will be updated with the Rekordbox key information. I set the analysis process to performance to make it the fastest analysis there is. However, that may slow down your computer. The last stop is the advanced tab. Right under the import library, this is where you define which Rekordbox XML is going to be used. To change the XML, simply browse to the storage location of the Rekordbox XML you want to use. And you can click this one away. Then we go to the Rekordbox XML part, and right there you see the contents of the XML. These contents are not yet inside the collection. Some tracks may be part of the collection, but they are not part of the collection yet. The easiest way to make all the playlists part of the collection is by right-clicking playlists and select import. This import can take some time for bigger collections, but when it's finished, all tracks from the XML are inside the Rekordbox collection and can be used to synchronize a CDJ, USB or whatever else and you welcome want. Welcome back to the Windows side of things. Let me fire up that Rekordbox for me. And like I just showed you in the already prepared footage, we go to the Rekordbox XML, we right click the playlists and import all the playlists. That will bring my tractor playlist right here. And if we take a look at the local playlist and we look at the track Professional Widow, where are we? There are we. By the way, those duplicates are FLAX and MP3s. This is a test collection, you have to understand. Then we can see that indeed we've got the cues and the loops. And look, those two loops that were reversed are now in the correct order. This is the B. This is the C. And everything is set as both hot and memory cues. That is how you convert a tractor collection Windows to a Rekordbox collection Windows. And like I showed you, you don't need all that stuff on the Macintosh. You can just let someone else do it who has a macOS, and you'll be a happy camper on Rekordbox Windows. Mixmaster G signing off.